Hey everyone, Shawn, Sav, and Mu, again at your service. Holy cow, we got an amazing show today. So many of you have been thinking about, well, how much side bend or head tilt do I need to execute my shots? We hear about that all the time, right? Mm-hmm. Fortunately for you, we've been teaching this for decades, and we have very, very simple analogies and exercises for you to get it right away without having to think about it or inserting a big hornet's nest and shaking it up. We'll see in a bit. But before the exterminator can do his work with you, we need for you to subscribe to our channel.
Please leave a comment down below and give us a big old thumbs up.
And please hit the bell so you never miss the videos.
You don't want to miss the videos because I'll sick Mu at you. So Sav, we did a really cool video last week with Ben Hogan and our diagonal stance. And we're going to pursue with you with the driver because you hit the ball so gosh darn well with the driver. And nothing is more important in the driver setup than the side bend, right? Than having the right tilt. And for many of you looking at this right now and you're thinking, well, how in the world do I get the right amount? Because I see so many of you trying to get into a side bending position and your balance is completely out of whack and you're setting yourself up for injury. And gosh darn, we don't want that, because we want you to play golf till you're 115 years old, like we are, all right? That's the plan, right? So now, how does it begin? Let me give, Sav, we're gonna start with a hammer for you. Because Sav is about to freaking hammer the crap out of this thing. And so, is that, okay, it's not our alarm, sorry about that. Now, if let's say we had a big nail that you wanted to drill into the ground, right? Take it with both hands, like your golf grip, right? And let's see you just get up there and slam it. So notice how your body is pretty level. I mean, you're moving your head out of the way so you don't hit yourself in the forehead with that thing, right?
Yeah.
So now in golf, where are we going? So if we're hammering that way, it's gonna look like this, isn't it? So how would you position, well, hang on. Yes. So does everybody see? Get into your golf full golf gear setup. There you go. Now you look like an athlete. So doesn't that look like she's able to hammer this thing in that direction? So now show me way too much side bend. Can you hammer through there right now? No, you're going to bend the crap out of this nail and have to, you know, do that all day. Now, show me way too little side bend. Doesn't that feel like you're just going to slam down on that nail?
Yeah.
Okay. Show me the one that you can drill this to the target with. Now, when we're driving the ball, because when we're talking about the angle of attack, now Rory likes about 3 degrees when he's driving for accuracy. And when he really wants to let it go, he's looking at 7 to 8 degrees, which is your zone. So that means that this here nail is just going to be angled at 7 degrees. So show me how you're going to set up to hammer up on this. Everybody see that right now? So let me give you another hammer, Sav.
My favorite
one. It's a Callaway hammer. This is very typical about how Mo used to do it. Notice how her club is not up against the ball right here. And look at the shoulders, how they're tilted. Now, your left hand is lower than your right hand on the club, or vice versa if you're a right-handed player, of course. And look at how strong her grip is. Notice how you see a lot of knuckles exposed here on her right hand, and how that left hand is under the club. Sav, wait a second. Hammer down. Notice as she's hammering down, there's your neutral grip, right? This is what you guys are hammering with. Hang on a second. Let go. How would that feel? Does that feel solid to hammer with? because it feels slappy.
Yeah.
Right? So if you want to slap the ball, go ahead and find a neutral grip with a square club face. And you'll notice that the vast majority of players on tour don't have that. So hammer down again. Now hammer through. See what she just did? And none of our students fail at this. They all do the same thing. So if I'm going to hammer down, then I'm going to get ready to hammer through. They all do this. Notice when I go hammer through, how my lead shoulder comes up and my trail shoulder comes down. And now I'm in a great position to hammer that way.
Yeah.
Okay. So if we were to overdo this, take your setup with the ball. Show me your stock setup. So notice right now, doesn't that look like she's getting ready to hammer it slightly on the way up for about 7 degrees to 8 degrees of angle of attack plus, right? Show me something that's way too little tilt. Do negative side bend. There you go. Doesn't that look like it's a pop fly in the making? She's gonna stick that sucker in the ground, get herself a real nice tennis or golf elbow, right? Not what you want. Now show me something that's way too much side bend. All right, so look at this beautiful out of balance body. Right now, you're just setting yourself up for some major back problems,
yeah.
Kinks, you know, QL issues, all that. So go ahead and set up again. I know you didn't like staying in that position, did you? So now this one feels balanced. It allows you to get the tip of the tee on the way up and to the left of the intermediate point. That's exactly what we're doing. So she's in a perfect position to hammer up on that ball while in balance. If you're in balance, you feel relaxed, right? So let me see you deliver to the left of the intermediate point on the way up. Boom. So we got draw. So tell me, Sav, did your setup feel comfortable?
90%.
Yeah. What felt out of whack?
I think because I was doing my open stance, and I went back to square, and it kind of felt a little...
What do you mean by open, by the way?
Just like...
So notice your front foot opens up a bit more.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that's fine, because... You want your feet toed open to allow you to have access to the target. So show me your open stance. Okay, so your feet are toed open. Now let's say you wanted to start the ball to the left of the intermediate point. How would you adjust your stance to be able to hammer up and to the left of that intermediate point? Does that give you access? Now, do you feel like you have to go lunge for it, or do you feel like it's available to you right now?
Okay.
Oh, that looks good. Excellent. Let's see you do that one. That started to the left. Excellent. Let's see you do one more like that. You're almost there. I threw you for a loop with all these tilts and negative tilts. Oh yeah. How did that feel?
That was the one.
It doesn't want to fall, Sav. Holy mackerel, there's 280. Center of the fairway. Okay, so you took it 2 degrees from the inside, 9 degrees up. Wow, right? right on the kisser.
And
only 2,000 RPM. So 2,000 RPM, little draw. So for 100 miles an hour, you milked that sucker for everything it was worth. 260 carry, 280 total. That's brilliant. So you see how we perform that task? Moo, you're up, buddy.
All right.
So here's another wonderful exercise. You get yourself a volleyball and Wilson, right? Yeah. The Wilson volleyball, that's important. This is the one we have from our Canadian volleyball team collection.
Yeah, that's right.
So you'll notice that if you wanted to get the volleyball to come up to a certain level, which is basically between this strip here and the floor, we want to deliver it there.
Yeah.
Show me how you would set up for that, Moo.
Okay.
And this is Moo training for his driver.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Good. So show me how you're going to be approaching that ball.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. So hang on.
Yeah.
Now you want to feel like you're going to be catching it slightly on the way up. So that ball should be a little more forward.
Yeah, that's right.
So you notice because of the size of the ball, we're looking for this.
Okay, yeah.
And so you're going to be approaching the ball from slightly under the equator.
Yeah, that's right. Underneath.
And then through to slightly above the equator. Can you see that in your mind?
Yeah.
Go ahead and set up.
Okay.
So we want that picture through the equator, slightly left of the intermediate point. Can you see it?
Yep.
Good.
I have access, yeah.
Let's do it. All right. So sorry there, Wilson. Let's see that again.
Okay.
You can close it a smidge more. There you go.
Yeah.
So you have that view of you delivering through the equator on that angle?
Yeah. Got it.
Oh my goodness, that was just pounded. So, again, for many of you, do it with a steel shaft. Do not do it with a graphite shaft.
Yeah, I learned that the hard way.
Yeah, we learned that the hard way, didn't we?
Yeah.
And, you know, take it easy on it. Don't do it too much. I don't want you developing a tennis elbow. But it is an amazing exercise for you to experience compressing the ball into a picture because the impact bags stop you dead in your tracks and it forces you to stop at impact. And that's not what we want. We want to feel like we're taking whatever object is from here and delivering it into the picture.
That's right.
Right?
Yeah.
So with the iron,
yeah,
like we just looked at what the tilt side bend would be with the driver.
Yeah.
With the iron, where would we want the low point to be, Moo?
Low point would be
yes.
Right here, just past the ball.
So with the golf ball and an iron, you're actually delivering through the opposite side of the equator, right?
Yeah, yeah.
So it's more down and through.
Yeah.
So if you were to take a setup right here next to the ball, like you're going to do a practice swing.
Okay.
Fantastic. Did you see where the divot was, you guys?
Yeah, right here.
So beautiful down here. So we catch the ball. Then we catch the grass, then we catch the ground, and then we exit ground and grass over here.
That's right.
Let's see you go ahead and set up.
Okay. went after the ball.
So
I felt close to the ball there.
That's all right. Now, yeah. What were you getting ready to do, Mu? Were you getting ready to squeeze the ball into your picture?
I was.
Or were you down here where, because we just talked about the angle that we're going to approach it on?
Yeah, I was thinking.
So you got mesmerized by the impact zone.
Yeah.
Good. So yeah. So this is what we don't want. So I'm glad that happened.
Yeah.
I threw all your attention down there and you went at it hook, line, and sinker, my buddy.
Yeah, I forgot about finishing over there.
So we want to do the same thing as the volleyball.
Yeah.
So let me see you deliver, compress the ball in this direction.
Yeah.
Using, you know, because when you're collecting from here and releasing out there, then you're activating that kinetic chain properly.
Right.
When you do, and this is one thing I want to show you guys.
What's up?
Actually, you stand right out here in front, Mu.
Okay.
So if I'm going to go in that direction towards this camera, I'm going to collect the ball from here. And one of my favorite players is doing really well this week, Joaquin Niemann. He's actually in second place right now at the Mayakoba. He's that's the ultimate collect and releaser of the ball. And you watch him how he collects here, that trail arm is so bent to the point where the lead arm is also a little bit bent. And then you see him extend both arms and legs into the picture. So we're going collect here, release there. So when you're squeezing the ball into your target, your kinetic chain really reacts well.
That's
all right?
True.
So that's the focus you should be on.
Okay.
You're gonna compress the ball to the left of the intermediate point. Using a nice flow of momentum. Yeah.
There we go.
Woo, yeah. Beautiful draw, man.
Thanks.
The hell iron do you have there?
7-iron, the new X-Forge from Callaway.
That is a forged blade.
Right.
You're not supposed to hit it that far, dude. So you just carried that 206.
Yeah. It felt good.
These
are really nice.
Your club head speed with a 7-iron was 103. That's savvy with the driver. Okay. So now notice that was 1.8 down.
Yeah.
Whereas the previous one.
Yeah, it was what? Did it register in the previous one?
It did. It would have been like 9 degrees up.
Okay, yeah.
So when you're tilted properly.
Yeah.
And you're going towards the target, go ahead and take your setup.
Yeah.
So show me in slow motion how you're going to collect that ball from where it is and deliver it in the direction you want to go.
Okay.
Super slow-mo. Come on down. Okay, good. So when your head is tilted here, this is what allows you to get past the ball with your lag.
Yeah.
So from here, if the lag goes through the ball, then the angle of attack with the club is going to be downwards.
Yeah.
But if you allow the club to pass your hands before the ball, then this fulcrum is now flipping the ball up. So now you got a plus angle of attack.
Oh, okay. That makes,
you see?
Yeah.
So there are two levers in the golf swing. So you have this one that you swing around.
Yeah.
So let's say I'm chipping, I play the ball back in my stance, I'm naturally going to hit it downwards.
Yeah.
But if I do this, notice if I activate that second lever, now I'm catching it on the way up.
Yeah, so you want to keep it that downward angle.
Well, it's not about that. It's about I'm going to go that way.
Right. You don't want to focus too much.
Don't worry about here at all.
Yeah.
So you want to take whatever you have in front of you, whether it's a volleyball or a golf ball, and you want to deliver it into the direction that you want to start it.
Right.
And then what happens, your kinetic chain engages and pulls everything through.
Yeah.
As it pulls everything through.
Yeah.
Look at my lag.
Right.
And then when I'm lagging,
then
I have a natural angle of attack, a natural downward angle of attack without having to think about it.
Right. You don't want, it's
okay.
Yeah.
So.
Just being an athlete about it.
Just being an athlete about it. Right, Sav? All right. I'm going to finish up with the righty version, and I'll show you guys another way to train the proper Side bend tilt. See you in a bit. Hammer down. Hammer through. Hammer down. Over the top. Go for that ball. Come on, go for that ball and just enjoy that over the top swing, right? Over OTT versus, all right, so we got, remember this. If I'm hammering down this way, I'll snap the shaft, the thing will bounce up. If, I didn't say the F word, did I?
No.
Okay, good.
No.
I was thinking it, but...
No, you didn't say it.
No, I didn't say it. Good. Yeah. It's important.
Yeah.
Thank you. So right here, it feels like I can deliver up and through the ball. Notice how I have to cup the ball. So to go up or to go along the ground, slightly down, it starts to bounce. That would be okay for the golf ball, of course. Now, the last one I wanted to show you is our beautiful grass whip. Now, we do have, Sav, you want to get the Wisdom of Golf grass whip? Now, in the meantime, like our best grass whip, by the way, is this one right here. It's this, you see the nice copper medallion right there. It's got a logo on it. It's got a nice heavy toe to really get that feel of that full release in there. But it also gives you way more than that. That's why it's really cool to practice with a grass whip. You can get something like this for $20 at your local hardware store, but the handle really sucks and you can't really, you know, it feels more like baseball instead of golf. And you got to put like a tennis wrap on it, stuff like that. But where this one, we have a nice golf grip on it and we have a golf shaft and you can use it just like a regular golf swing. If you wanted to cut grass along the ground and not do damage to the backyard, you don't want anybody yelling at you for taking, you know, big chunks out of the backyard. So watch what happens here. I'm going to close this thing and I'm going to get ready to move along the ground. So you see my position now? So right now, as I'm delivering towards the target, the blade can come in relatively square. It looks really open right now. It begins the cut here, ends the cut there. So notice as the cut is ending, it is square, and then it releases. Now, if I go after the ball, it would look like this. Now I'm taking a big chunk out of the ground. So many of you don't realize that you actually change tilts during the swing or change your side bend. That means that you're changing your focus. So you go up and down the driving range, you're gonna see a lot of people starting like this, and at the top of the backswing, they look like this. Then they wonder why they're over swinging, out of balance, reverse tilting, really simple. That's the target.
Yeah.
So if I want the target to be over there and I want this to go to the target, then it would start to look like this. Now, the other ones who are over tilted, well, those are the ones trying to scoop it up.
Yeah.
Come on, please get up in the air.
Yeah.
Whereas you need to understand that your golf club is designed to cut grass first and foremost. So if all we do is we follow the ground with the sole of the club, watch my side bend. Do you see any changes there? Of course not, because I'm staying with me cutting along the grass in the direction I want the ball to go. If I follow the ground, I don't gouge the ground. I do a really good job at cutting grass. And your golf club is designed first and foremost to cut grass. Phil Mickelson was using these Callaway Epic Forged at the Masters because the grass was actually being mowed from the tee, from the greens back to the tee boxes, and they were leaning back against you.
Yeah.
And you know, you needed a leading edge that was a little more round that wouldn't catch in that.
Yeah.
Center gravity a little lower and a springier face. And then if you hit it thin with this club, it doesn't spin as much. Whereas with the iron you just hit before,
yeah,
if you didn't have the proper surface and it spun too much, you would lose 20 yards like that.
Right.
Well, you can't afford to lose 20 yards, especially not on holes like number 15 yeah. at Augusta National.
Yeah, you can't.
Then the ball's coming back in the water and it's over.
Yeah.
So I've got my grass cutting tool. I'm getting ready to cut grass along the surface of the ground. I can still go that way. I can still go that way. Now I'm just going to give myself a little bit of momentum and go in that direction. So notice the contact with the ground was absolutely fantastic. There's a easy 200 yard carry because, and many of you are actually going to hit the ball longer with that side bend. So notice I'm 3.7 downwards, hit the ball right there, very close to the center of the face. Notice I'm coming in from the inside, just 2 degrees closed, and there's that beautiful draw. So I carried that 197 yards, probably a couple of hops on the green. My club speed, unlike Moo, is at 95 instead of 103. Okay. So you notice, if I were to default to the ball, now I'm moving down after the ball. When I get ahead of it, now my low point's over here. So that means I have to reach back. So for all of you who get out in front, you feel like you're losing your lag, you're reaching back, is because you lost your side bend. Why did you lose your side bend? You lost your focus on the target. So why did you lose your focus on the target? You let the ball become your target. If I'm cutting through this dandelion in the direction of the target, so have a look at our grass whip training video. So grass whip training, Shawn Clement on YouTube. It is an absolute fabulous video to get you the right task that you need to conserve the side bend that you need for you to execute your shots the way you want to, okay? So hope you enjoyed that as much as we did.
Yep.
And we'll see you all next week. All the best. Don't forget to subscribe and that notification bell.